Hello. So, welcome.
Welcome to the finale of the Super Reborn Marathon,
where we look at the new Super Mario Bros. Games
and decide what we think about them.
So, last time we looked at the Super SE and SMB2. And funnily enough, released the same year, just 4 months apart. No, seriously, it would be July. But the game was released the same year as 2. But with that being said,
and which one is better? Let's find out.
So the game was released on November 18th.
There it is again.
And something about
November 18th.
November 18th into 21st. Okay. Well, aside from that. But the game was released with. I'm gonna actually look it up. Yeah, the game was launched on the Wii U. AKA Nintendo's
Virtual Boy sequel. In terms of sales. We're actually proud of is a Wii U.
Yeah.
Otherwise, how would you get this review if you were first hand experience?
The game was a launch title. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a Mario game at launch. That's the first time I'm.
N64. Yeah. This happened on our home console.
Well, if you don't count Luigi's Mansion.
Anyway, I skip Luigi.
Yeah. So the game was received pretty well. With nothing lower than an 84 or. And the highest being a 9.1.
So the general consensus was pretty the same.
I wish I could say the same for other people. Also, this was Mario's first HD adventure. And it sold 5.75 million units.
Which isn't the best.
Did I mention the game got DLC?
In the form of New Super Luigi.
Basically a second
we'll be reviewing them in the original game. Then we'll be reviewing what Luigi U does better.
Honestly, it took forever for us to get the game. And Alex actually bought Luigi U for physically.
Yep.
For Christmas. That's alongside the Wii U. And it wasn't until 2 months ago, when we actually picked up the game.
So
the story, the opening cutscene.
It's just a tea party you're playing at.
And
Bowser just casually scoots Peach away and grabs everyone else and throws them.
And also, the Koopalings airships!
They have their own airships now.
I remember seeing this with Austin in years ago.
It's honestly the most absurd intro to any Mario game.
He doesn't steal the princess?
Oh, instead he's taking over the castle.
Wonderful. Oh, so it's up to Mario, Luigi, and, ignore these. These two nameless toads.
So, John and Dan, as we're calling them. John the yellow one, and Dan the blue one.
Our heroes set off. off to save the princess. Basic shit. Yeah, but seriously, you gotta love that opening cutscene.
Yeah.
It's not as stupid. It's not as facepalm worthy as Wii's. Ethan, it's not as random as the original. Oh. So, how many power-ups were introduced here?
One.
Yeah, just one.
We only got one new power-up in this game.
Just one. Let's see where this is coming from.
We only got one new power-up for this game.
And that is... Let's go over it.
The Flying Squirrel.
The Super Acorn.
The Super Acorn.
It earns Mario and do well.
Earl
and Owen allows him to glide and through the air and just once do a jump. Also,
after doing the boost, you'll glide a much slower descent. The cover distance much less faster, descend much slower, so you're basically falling with a slight boost air cut.
Also, believe it or not, well, if you technically count these as power-ups,
yeah.
Holy sh!
The baby Yoshis!
Yes, remember those from Mario World? You fed them in a oven, and then
and they grow up? These are just babies. They don't grow up. So what would you give the Super Acorn?
Well,
10.
Yeah, I'll give it a 10 too. And then let's go over them in order. The pink Yoshi. It turns into a balloon.
One that lets you gain extra air power.
I dare you to use this with the Super Acorn.
It's even funnier.
You'll get so much.
You get to glide and then use Yoshi.
That's just crazy.
It replaces your jump. It replaces your midair jump, but still.
Oh yeah. That's just absurd. But also, rating for this one.
I'll give this one a...
Come on. What would you give the pink one?
I'll give the pink Yoshi a 10.
Yeah, 10. And there's, the...
Indigo Yoshi.
The blue, this one.
Yeah.
What does it do? Okay, it turns enemies into bubbles. Yeah. Those with coins. But wait, it can do more than that. You can bounce off those bubbles.
Yep.
Yep, you heard me. You can bounce off the bubbles. It's just crazy.
It is.
Reading for this?
Ready for
the
it's
kind of situational.
It's a little situational compared to the pink yet.
Yeah, I'll give it an 8 too.
Now we also have
and last but not least, only in Ghost's House.
And arguably most useful one.
The
Glowchi, as we call it.
Yeah.
Glowchi.
Yeah, the yellow one, I guess.
No, not really yellow, golden.
Yeah, the Glowchi.
Mm-hmm. Really? Yeah. Why do you always do that?
What?
Just go over and stare at the screen whenever it really stops.
I don't know. What does it do? It as our
it's light around.
Uh-huh.
The only guard it does is blow away ghost enemies and light up dark rooms.
Yeah, that's about it.
It blows away ghosts and cause scary rats to turn around.
Oh, but...
It can eat booze.
Also, this thing is in, like, what, 3 levels?
I think.
Not sure. Oh, but it's 9 a lot.
It's got a lot of levels compared to the others.
Also, did I mention that these things can... Yeah, I'll give it a 6, too. These things can go with you.
I'm like a double Yoshi in this game, who don't lose you behind after you beat a level.
Yeah.
The baby Yoshi stick with you. Assuming you don't drop them.
Which, that can happen.
Assuming that... the requirement for them to be, to pass on with you to the level, they can't enter bosses, but...
Yeah, they can't, yeah.
But if you beat... But if you beat a regular level with them, yeah, basically they can enter any most levels of the flying color, except for the little sassy.
Yeah.
So, then you're gonna throw them beyond the pole, and then... and then hit it yourself.
Yep.
And they'll come with you.
I'd say
just star 9.
Yeah.
You never rated the glow sheet.
I gave it a 6.
Oh, okay.
So, what else is there? There's the Koop... The Koopling... And have their own fights again. Junior's back. Kamek is too...
not much in terms of boss fight.
Yeah, not much in terms... Oh, wait! Boom Boom's back.
Yeah,
but you can kill him in a... in about 10 seconds.
For some reason, this game started, it would make a lot of sense to introduce a single unique boss. Giant sumo girl, which only appears in one fortress.
In Rock Candy Mines.
In one of the Rock Candy Mines fortresses. As you know, World 6 has 2 fortresses in these games. Is that a thing in Wii?
No. No.
Just in you and the original. Oh, yeah. You and the original has 2 fortresses in some way. And in the second fortress of World 6, it's Rock Candy Mines. And then you also deal with this guy.
Yeah.
He basically just functions the same as the Super Bowl, except he jumps between. With 3 different platforms.
Oh, so you gotta do it Mario Bros. Style.
You gotta hit him from beneath, and then he'll drop down.
Oh, no,
you have to jump on him.
Yeah.
Jump on his side.
Yeah, that's it.
Mm-hmm. Right. You get the boss.
I mean, what about yours first?
You need to decide things.
Well, it's kind of easy.
Yes. Well, it's not a very entertaining boss fight.
I mean, at least. Yeah. I'll give it a 7.
I'll give it a 9. So it's an 8.
Yeah. So, what else is there? Also, you might have mentioned, might have heard him say, instead of World 6.
Not any line.
That's right.
Drop the world numbering system here.
I mean, all of them are connected. All the, just like Mario World.
Are connected on the map. Awesomely enough. Of course, with the exception of World 8. And a part art of World 5.
Right. That means there are a lot of ways to...
To traverse this place.
A lot of ways to... You can... And,
of course, there's plenty of fourth paths.
And a bunch of speedrunning possibilities.
Secret exits approach.
To go over the second half. Yes.
Luigi U has a few minor differences.
Well, one...
First off, every character has Luigi's trademark physics. Luigi doesn't have his own unique physics in Mario U for some reason.
Why?
Same with Luigi. But this time, every character has Luigi's physics. You're like, why would Mario have Luigi's physics? Mario's not in Luigi U.
Alex has a dark theory.
You know, Luigi slowly slips into insanity after Mario died.
Hell, where's the evidence? Mario's hat at his scene in...
But he's not there at the tea party?
In Frosted Glacier, you see
Mario's snowman in the middle of a frosty wasteland.
And then there's a block
where you can hinder yourself by giving yourself Mario's feelings.
I guess that's,
Luigi attempting to...
It's weird. Yeah. It's a weird theory, Alex.
Yeah.
Don't take it too seriously. So that's right. Luigi's trademark physics for turning a 2D game. There's a new character introduced for these games.
Nabbit. Is Nabbit a playable character? Well, Luigi, you know. Originally, he just steals items and you have to chase him down.
He steals PA horns.
PA horns and you have to chase him down.
You wonder what those are?
They're the
Super Acorn.
Super
Acorn with infinite jump.
Super version of Super Wii. Except you have an infinite jump. And you never go into the phase where you're descending.
Yeah. Nabbit is playable in Luigi U. Either from holding down on the Z-E-E-E triggers, or... Resort A and B. You can play as Nabbit, and he's completely invincible.
Yep. The only if it's not instant death, it won't kill Nabbit.
But if it's something,
like crushing or thing,
you can still die.
You can still die from being crushed, getting off screen, or.
Also, Nabbit has this ability, as the ability of
collecting items along the way.
And that'll give you a maximum of 8 lives.
You get a maximum of up to 8 lives for all the items you collect. For all the different power-ups you collected. Nabbit can't use dodge. He's constantly in his super form, I guess.
Yeah.
Not that Nabbit would really need power-ups in most cases.
This is just broken.
In most cases. I still kind of wish you could have Flying Squirm at it.
Yeah. But Nabbit, but Nabbit comes with one huge flaw.
Two. Oh. One, knockback. Oh god, knockback. If it doesn't kill you, it's a more solid object, like a womp or a spike, it's gonna knock you back.
That can get you killed
very easily. And the other drawback as I've said, you can't use power-ups, so certain star coins or laser secret engines are impossible to reach with.
However, or you think...
And there's also a level that... or the mini mushroom. There are a few cases.
Yeah.
And even in one case, you need to be small throughout the course of the level to get a good finish it.
Yeah.
So you can't use magic, like. So,
You're wondering, but isn't this like a super guide?
It has no effect on your progress.
So, you go ahead. Alex told me to do a playthrough where I didn't use Nabbit.
That's ridiculous.
I did my recent playthrough where I use Nabbit a lot. To bullshit it in a lot of things. Alright, let's get into the Starcoin territory. Shall we?
Yep.
So, the Starcoins are back once again. And to give the player an incentive to explore the stages.
And this time, your reward is just like we. You get an extra level per.
It's like we and two.
We and two. You get an extra level for each star coin you collected. For each world you finish the starter. It's not like two. You need all the star coins.
Oh, yeah, you need all of them.
Yeah, it's just like we, where you need to collect all the star coins. In any given world to unlock its correspondent up on the extra level. World 9. Mm-hmm. And after you've collected the end all the world 9 levels, you collect all the star coins there.
You get 5 stars. Ours.
It's better than Luigi U, actually, given the fact that instead of playing as Nabbit, since, Nabbit can't really complete this one because...
Yeah, the final level.
Or because it requires the flying squirrel suit.
You play as...
You're me.
Yeah, that's something we didn't really touch on.
In challenges, or in this specific level, you can play as your me.
It's just cosmetic.
Hey,
but hey, at least you can see your me.
And near the end of the level is one of those face things where you can put your me's face on a Luigi cutout.
Yeah. Yeah.
that's a really neat touch. I like that. It's cool that they actually give you a level for completing the World 9 level.
Yeah. Side quest rating?
Maybe it was 10.
Yeah, 10.
And as for the... by the way, let's just go over the world names. Why not? First we have Acorn Plains.
Plains?
Which is your grasslands level.
Rare
Cake Desert, which is your desert level. Sparkling Waters, which is your water level.
Actually, this is where the game gives you a choice.
Yeah, actually, after Rare Cake Desert, you get a choice between Sparkling Waters or Frosted Glacier, which is your ice level.
Soda Jungle.
Then you get Soda Jungle, which is your jungle world. I love soda!
Okay.
And then you move on to Rock Candy Mine. Your mountain world.
And then Meringue Cloud.
Cloud World.
And
finally,
Peach's Castle.
Well, Peach is technically your food, so...
Yeah.
And
then there's Superstar Road.
You need a Superstar Road.
Yeah, I know food name. In there.
Unless the characters actually eat the invisibility stars.
I don't know.
How would smoke some of these power ups even taste? Who would eat a penguin suit?
I don't know. Also, if you're wondering in what. So, are the propeller and penguin suit.
Back?
Well, in Mario U,
in Mario U, They're completely absent, and they're only obtainable for the item houses in Superstar Road.
Oh.
In Luigi U, they're actually given to you both in item houses in the regular world and by playing through levels.
So yes, they're...
So in Luigi U, they're fully integrated into the game, and in Mario U, they're completely...
Gameplay.
And it's definitely a 10.
And
this is actually the most solid gameplay in the series. It's a ton of fun, and the level design is fair. And I just have a blast with this game.
Yeah, you had a blast playing. And then I'll give the gameplay a 10 as well.
So and there's the music. The music is mostly reused from Wii, but they actually did bother adding new original tracks this time.
Such as the overworld.
Such as the completely unique overworld.
Older now, athletic.
On the new athletic. See, I could main teams.
Also, the Yoshi sing.
Yes. There's a challenge mode in Mario U. Not Luigi U for some reason, but Mario U has a challenge mode.
You can play as the other characters?
Why didn't you do that in single player in the regular game?
Seriously! If they're just skins,
why can't you play as them?
Music rating?
I'll give it a 10.
Yeah. Same.
I'll give this game a 10.
10.
These games were a blast. I gladly experienced them again.
Seriously. The Mario U games
are the best in the series. And definitely pick them up if you want a Wii U and don't have them already.
Yeah, we own a complete physical collection.
Funnily enough, we own a complete physical collection of all the new Super Mario Bros. Games and all the 3D Mario games.
Yeah.
Which is really funny.
And Paper Mario.
All the Paper Mario.
Well, almost.
Almost all the Paper Mario games. You don't own a physical copy of Mario 64.
I think this video should be.
For the RPG series, we also don't own a physical copy of the original.
All right, I think we get it. Okay. They get it.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna spend the rest of this video, talking about viewing these games critically.
A lot of people say that these games, because they did not innovate it on the formula, are complete garbage. Which is ridiculous.
And they're easy.
Which is also kind of ridiculous.
Yeah. Look, guys. I'll be saying this time and time again. And innovation doesn't matter. Innovation doesn't matter. What matters most
is definitely. What matters most here is definitely how fun it is, and this game has that in spades.
And I know our opinions have been a little abnormal.
Well, for this series,
is
who cares about that?
We
all have our own opinions.
But this has been the Super Reborn Marathon,
and I am so glad. Thank you so well.
We got
so
to
much.
Relive some memories
and experience. And it's a game or two we haven't already.
So, with that being said, I'm Nezren.
And I'm Aaron, and thank you.
And bonjour.
Bonjour, my wonderful viewers, and thank you all for sticking with us.